Under Mary, Bloody Mary as she became known, the persecution of Protestants caused deep religious conflict across the country. Worse, this Catholic queen spoke openly of handing her throne to the Spanish king. Walter Raleigh was born between 1552 and 1554, at the height of this period, now known as the Marian persecutions. His family, which was devoutly Protestant, suffered accordingly. During one disturbance, his father, a Devon farmer, was nearly hanged by a Catholic mob. As a result, his son learned to hate both Catholics and Spain, both vividly recalled in tales of the cruel Spanish Inquisition. After Queen Elizabeth came to the throne in 1558, the country began to settle into a period of calm. Slowly, trade and industry began to recover. Rid of the distractions, Englishmen began to explore the seas once more, defying Spanish dominance. Raleigh was the younger of two sons, but through family connections, he was able to further himself adequately. As a young man, he had the opportunity of joining ships belonging to relatives, such as the famous Drakes or the Grenvilles, and learning the ropes on trading expeditions. But instead, he opted to go to Oxford to study. Although his wit made an immediate impression there, John Aubrey relates, in his brief accounts, that Raleigh was not a wealthy student.
In his youth, for several years, he was under straits for want of money. I remember that Mr. Thomas Child of Worcestershire, he told me that Sir Walter borrowed a gown of him when he was at Oxford. They were both of the same college, which he never restored, nor money for it.
At this time, one of Raleigh's cousins married a Huguenot leader, Count de Montgomery. Whether for reasons of poverty or duty, he soon left Oxford to fight with him in France against the Catholics. He remained in France for 4 years. There, experience of war at its most savage dampened his romantic streak. As a soldier, he came to appreciate the need for ruthlessness and strong leadership. When he returned to England, he was a grown man.
He was a tall, handsome and bold man, oh, but damnable proud, oh. Old Sir Robert Hardy of Brampton Bryan Castle, who knew him, would say that it was a great question who was the proudest, Sir Walter or Sir Thomas Avebury, but the difference that was judged on Sir Thomas' side. Oh, he had a most remarkable aspect, an exceeding high forehead, long-faced and sour-lidded, a kind of piggy eye. His beard turned up naturally.
On his return to England, he again took up study at Oxford. There, he also resumed an interest in dueling and brawling.